Everybody, it's Julie. Thanks for joining me today. We're using the February Faith Art Box from Creative Retreat. And this kit is just so precious. Look at this stamp set. You can see I've already had fun with it because my stamps, some of them are already discolored. It comes, instead of the bows this month, it comes with these enamel hearts and shapes and these beautiful colors. And these stickers. I love the stickers, this variety. Lindsay on our design team has done a wonderful unboxing. So check up here in the right-hand corner. I have linked her unboxing video that's on her channel. So you can see what in detail comes in this kit. She just talks about it. But this devotional written by Caitlin Wernett that comes in the kit focuses on God's great love, His perfect love, His pure love, His unconditional love. It's not the love that we focus on a lot here in February with Valentine's Day, the romantic, gushy, mushy love. It's that perfect love, and it's only by growing in God's love that we can love others and truly love others. So that's what we're doing here today. We're focusing on God's perfect love and how by His love and because He loved us first, we can love others. And that's in 1 John 4:19, and that's the passage that we are journaling today. Actually, this entire chapter is just wonderful, 1 John 4, but I'm focusing primarily on verse 19. I'm starting off by putting down a wash of blue. This is watercolor, just getting a little wash of it. I'm making sure that I add lots of water to it. So every time I take my brush off the screen, I'm just adding a little bit of water to lighten that down. And then sometimes I actually pick up the pigment a little bit more with my water, with my brush. I just want a little bit of background so it looks kind of like sky. And then I highlight the verse there. And the verse says, we love because God first loved us. And I'm starting here. Now you can see those are stems. I'm going to make a bouquet of flowers. And this was actually inspired by an Instagram friend, Patio Ponderings. About a couple of weeks ago, she made a really cute field of flowers using hearts. And I decided I wanted to do that too. I'm actually stamping here with the watercolors. So I first just painted the stems, and then I decided I don't want to get out ink. I'm just going to use the watercolor that I have here. So I just kind of paint onto the stamp. And this is the stamp from the kit. It's the greenery and it's curved. So I'm trying to curve it the opposite direction slightly so that when I go to the other side of the bouquet, it's not going to be in the same direction. You want kind of the opposite directions. I've got sprigs coming out. Now I'm going to cover this up so I'm not too worried about it being precise. And besides, a bouquet of wildflowers is never precise, is it? That's the beauty of a wildflower bouquet, or even any kind of bouquet. They're rarely symmetrical. So now I'm coming in first with just the watercolor, the green. Now I'm coming in with some black, but I'm making sure that I stamp the ink off first, and then I'm just getting the second generation inking, the second generation stamp. So it's much lighter. I just want the impression here of this greenery. I'm channeling my inner Monet with impressionism. Yeah, we'll go with that. I'm adding in some of the green on these leaves here, and then just a little bit of the teal to give it some depth too. Now all of this is going to be not completely covered, but this is where I'm going to add my flowers. When you give a bouquet of roses or flowers to someone, it's to show love and appreciation. And next week when Valentine's Day comes, you know, my husband will often give me flowers, or sweethearts give flowers to each other. And this is reminiscent of that. This is in honor of that. It's about God's love to us, how He loved us first. In this whole chapter, it talks about how God showed His love, not by giving us a bouquet of flowers, but by sending His Son Jesus to die on the cross for us, to live and die for us. And it's only because of that love that we can love others. We can respond in love to him, and then we can grow in love. So this bouquet of roses, of flowers, these heart flowers, because I'm going to make the hearts into the flowers, is symbolic of that. The love that God gives to us to show his pure and perfect love for us. And then also the growth that we need to do in him. And it's only by growing in love for him that we can love others. So now I added some stickers that say, because he, and now I'm going to stamp the word loved, and it says me first. It's going to say, because he loved me first. So I use my powder tool first to get off all the static and anything like that that the embossing powder would stick to. And I'm stamping the word loved, and I'm stamping this bow down here. That was with a blue pigment ink, which you can emboss with. And now I'm adding a crystal clear embossing powder. And what that does is it allows the blue to show underneath, and then it's going to give it kind of a shiny effect. The problem, though, this is a fail that I did. The problem is that I kept that paper towel underneath my page, which meant that I did not get a very dark impression with my ink. So now I'm hoping that the powder, when it dries, the embossing powder is going to darken up, but it doesn't. So you can still see through the bow. And now I'm heating the word loved up there, and it's not darkening, and I'm waiting, and I'm actually letting it dry too long, and I ended up burning the page. You can see how it yellowed. That's from burning it. So don't do as I just did. I'm going to end up using the sticker to cover up the word loved, which I could have just used the sticker in the first place. Well, anyway, that's how we fix things. That's how we make mess ups. That's how we fix things. Now I'm going to just rearrange my stickers a little bit to make it balance out some. And then I'm going to end up here. I'm going to put my hearts on, but I'm going to end up fixing that bow by just doing it on cardstock and fussy cutting it. And then I'll emboss that. I'll just show you where I stamp it, and then I will do that off screen. So now I'm adding in my hearts. These are my flowers. I'm using the three colors here, the blue, the pink, the darker pink, the darker peach, and then the lighter peach. And I'm alternating the colors so that none of them are right next to each other. I'm not going for symmetry. Notice that the three blue hearts, the three peach hearts, they form a triangle, and then I actually only have two of the darker peach. I want an uneven number, an odd number, because that makes it more natural looking and more pleasing, especially since I'm going for this look of a wildflower bunch. And now I use these enamel hearts, and see how those colors just match perfectly? So I'll pull out a peach, a pink, and a blue, and then I also pull out some of those enamel dots, the circle dots, and I flank the word me up there. I'm going to come in now with my precision pen, my black pen, and just outline these words, the word Fetty, and the heart stickers to make them pop off the page a little bit. And here's what I always do. Well, not always, but I usually don't take it slowly enough, and I'm not careful, and then I get a stray mark going across something. And I did that on one of the hearts. And so then that means that I have to come later and fix it by adding my black splatter paints. That's usually why I do my black splatter paints, is to cover up a mess up, like where I had a stray black mark. You might not have known that secret, but that's my reveal. So now you can see the little heart, the little bow that I did. I did that off screen and just fussy cut it. I did the embossing, and you'll see in the close-up shot how it is kind of shiny and shimmery. It's pretty cool. Before I put the bow on and I added some foam dimensional tape to it, I'm adding some wispy stems there, not real dark. I wanted it light, again, just to give the impression of the stems. And now I put the bow on it. So that looks like that bow just ties this whole bouquet together. So I just thought that that was so sweet the way it turned out. And it just reminds me of God's sweet love for me, and God's sweet love that allows me to then in turn love my husband perfectly. It's not that my love for him is perfect, but God's love for me is perfect, and I can then share that love with my husband and with others, with my friends, with my neighbors, with my children, That's the love that we want to share with others. So I'm making a clip now, actually out of the tabs that came from the sticker sheet. Since there were two of them and they already have the adhesive on them, I'm just putting them back to back, and I put a clip between them. And look at that cute little clip that it made up there at the top. And you just stick that right up on the top of the page. I like doing that sometimes, and it just sticks up at the top. Now I'm using these alpha tiles to spell out the text, 1 John 4:19, but here's another mess up that I make. Because when I was boxing the text, I covered up the 1 in the number 19, and so now, there you see, I put 4:9 instead of 4:19. And I don't realize that I do that until later on when I'm looking at my still shots. So I go back and I do fix that. So in the still shot, you'll see how I fix it. I cut down the colon and then I make that smaller and then add in the 1. So check that out in the pictures at the end. I just box those. This kit is just so awesome. It's versatile. It's got wonderful stamps, wonderful stickers in it. Make sure that you pick yours up. I provide the link for the Creative Retreat shop in the comments section. You want to get yours. It is just so much fun, and I've done some wonderful things already with it. And check out the blog post where I've written just a little more heart behind this. Check out also what other ladies have done with their kits. And subscribe to this kit. It's just a wonderful deal. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Give this video a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, leave them in the comments section. And next time, come back and join me. Thanks so much. Bye-bye.